I don't pretend to be nice, but I'll be nice after this intro. It's to the point of being embarrassing. How many comments from either content consumers, so the viewers, or content creators saying things along the lines of, but we're already back 50K, or does your analysis change now that Bitcoin's back above 50K? No, watch Toy Story. Bitcoin is falling with style. It's really super simple. So let me show you in the charts so that in the near future, you won't be one of those people making those comments that just grinds my gears. Ah! Okay, I'll be nice now. So my chart is very clearly labeled here. I want you to put your eyes on these four items in front of you. Whenever you see a red box, that means a daily trend was making higher highs and higher lows, and then it stopped and made a lower low in daily price. It made a lower low trend reversal. A green box means the same thing, but opposite. Downtrend, lower highs, lower lows, and then you had a trend reversal where you had a higher high and a higher low, something to that effect. A pink scribble, so kind of like how I'm scribbling here, but pink, is where I highlight the moments that Bitcoin's falling with style. If you get a blue line, it is to signify this isn't falling with style because Bitcoin was in a daily uptrend. It is a skim play during the correction. It's not falling with style. This would be something to celebrate. Yes. If people right now were saying after an uptrend, maybe a 20% correction, and it's still an uptrend, yes, we're back above 50K. Absolutely. But we are falling with style. So let me show you the difference. And I will start in 2019. Start with this uptrend digging out of after the capitulation of 2018 bear market. This happened November 14th. It fell down, stayed down here all of January 2019, went to 3,200, then raced to 14K. All right. You had a pretty severe dip here, right? Check that out. 16%. I mean, it happened fast. But if you take a look, a skim play means you take two EMAs, the 10 and 21. If they don't fully cross and then price makes a lower high, that is a skim play. Sometimes skim plays get deep where the red goes a little bit under the yellow, but that's just a deep skim play. But this is a skim play. So if people right now were celebrating something after a dip like this, and these never crossed because we didn't break an uptrend, okay, then yeah, if we're back up here, yes, time to celebrate. That is a skim play, and you probably want to be pretty bullish on that. So that is the confusion. People are thinking, what is happening right now is this, but it is not. It is going to be the pink lines. All right, so let's not focus on the boxes yet. The boxes will be last. The pink lines. So take a look. You had the cross here. It price or the EMAs uncrossed here, but then they quickly went straight back. So you did create a lower low in price. Let me change my marker to orange now. It tried to uncross, but then went right back down. All right, now, after you had this recross, okay, see how the EMAs right here crossed? See how the red goes below the yellow? But you were now in a downtrend. You have a red box. You made a lower low. The trend is now broken. The trend is down. Lower low, lower high. So when you go back below it and price gets above the 10 EMA, it's likely going to drop until you're in an uptrend. Until a green box happens. So likely every, so this is falling with style. So take a look, it went up 14% in 6 days. So that's what people are celebrating right now. Oh, it went down to 9,600. Oh, we're already back to 11K. No, you had a reversal. The EMAs crossed. This is falling with style. Don't celebrate this stuff. All right. Another one. Like, yeah, we're up 15% in 2 days. We were at 9,400. We're already back up to 11K again, twice in a month. No, you're still falling with style. The EMAs haven't crossed and you haven't formed a higher high or a higher low. It's falling with style. All right. Okay. So another one. And this, honestly, this price action around this time was really tricky. It was a massive sloppy consolidation. It was hard to trade after this 14K top until roughly October 2020 when it was clear to me that bull market was happening. So this was all very hard to trade. Actually, pretty tricky stuff. Another fake out. So this looked like a good trend reversal. But guess what happened? When price tried to form a higher low, it could never stick the landing and it made a lower low. So because there was no higher low, even though you did make a higher local high, the trend was still net up. You have to form the higher low in days. So as it was trying to find a higher low, nope, I actually found a lower low. So this was a pretty embellished. I mean, this was an exaggerated falling with style, so I didn't circle it, but technically it's this was tricky. I mean, that was like really hard to play. It went straight up and went straight down. So that's not a typical one. All right, another typical one. So look, the EMAs are still crossed. Let's take off price just to, you know, keep your eyes on this. See the cross? See how this crosses down? Okay, after that happens, when price goes up 18% in 4 days, don't be one of those people who says, yay, we are up 18%. I told y'all that's the bottom. No, you're falling with style. The trend is down. These EMAs are crossed. The red's below the yellow. All right. Now, after a green box, and look how price or the EMAs, the red crossed above the yellow. So you're no longer falling with style. So each little dip, the red's on top. Good to go. But uh-oh, it crossed again. See how the red goes below the yellow? So anytime price screams up above the 10 EMA, it went 9% in just a few days. People celebrating, ha, we were already back up to 9,200. Just like people saying, we're already back up to 50K. Does this change your analysis? No. These EMAs are crossed. It is a downtrend. Toy Story, Buzz freaking Lightyear. Actually, I said I was going to be nice, but I'm not being nice. All right, so I'm going to get to the boxes here shortly. We're almost done with these. Just watch. The boxes really are freaking important, and it has to do with the crosses. Again, this was really sloppy price action. This was hard to trade. Yeah, 80 days. This was hard stuff to trade. I mean, really, one of the most successful trading styles could have been like levels or just not trading at all for almost 100 days. This was tricky stuff, but you had the cross. Do you see how price... take off price, it crossed. So the first attempt up, guess what? You're likely falling with style. Now, it was able to find a higher low after this, but it still went back down and retested the lows. You're still falling with style. Could that be what's happening now and we find a higher low like this? Maybe. And I actually think this is the fractal, and this fractal and these two fractals are what's playing out. So I'm kind of a fan of that theory. But it's not statistically probable. There's no reason to celebrate. We're over 50K. All right, so look how massive this drop was. This isn't falling with style. Look, 30% drop. Why isn't this falling with style? Look, because it was a skim play. The trend was up. They hadn't crossed down. So any major dip, it has a strong chance of being okay. Right? It hadn't crossed. So when price got back above, this is likely not falling with style. Something like this, if the 10 EMA were on top of the, or skimming on the yellow, yeah, celebrate. We're back up to 34K. Sure, that is cool, right? But what's happening now is not cool. Another big correction. Red on top of yellow. Skim play. It landed on it like a plane. See? Yes, you celebrate. We were down here and we're already back up to, and this is actually 50K. We're back up to 50K. Yes, celebrate that. Because the red's on top of the yellow. Toy Story and Sesame Street. So here, red box, you had a trend reversal. Look. So see how this crossed? So the first time price zooms up 26% in 11 days. You know how many people thought, oh, I'm a genius. I'm bullish, right? Now, if you long this and took profits here, yeah, you probably were a genius. And this is where I take profits. If I ever catch a low and then did cross, I take my profits there. I don't assume it's going to go up because it's probably statistically not likely. So yeah, so people were saying, yes, and we're back up. Now, was I one of those people? Absolutely. I don't want to be hypocritical. There was a reason I did that, but I should have just looked at the Bitcoin chart. Ethereum was making all-time highs to 4K, and Cardano was flying to $3. I really thought this was going to take off, but shame on me. It was falling with style, and I was distracted by the manipulation of Ethereum and Cardano to the upside. And if you think that was retail and normal people pushing those up, you are friggin' mistaken. It was all part of the plan, and I got sucked into it. So shame on me. I broke this rule. Have I been in that boat before? Yes, we're already here. I have been. Ethereum and Cardano just making insane higher highs, thinking Bitcoin's going to catch right up. And I thought that was going to trump this area, and it sure didn't. Bitcoin was king. You had a 32%. Like, look, this dwarfs what we have going on. People celebrating, yay, back up to 40K. No, you're falling with style. You don't have a green box yet. Still falling with style, right? Okay, so... Another one, just the most recent one, red cross the yellow, cross below the yellow here. You see that? Okay. So your first push up, you had 12% in 3 days. I think that's still bigger than what we've had. And no, it wasn't time to celebrate. Now, it actually, this did look like a skim play. So there was actually pretty good reason. So kind of look at this. It didn't fully cross. This did look like it was going to be a skim play. So you were kind of in a defensive mode there. That was hard to play right there. So these rules aren't like don't have a fail safe, right? Like they sometimes mess up. So here, this skim play, it did end up turning into a full on reversal. This one was hard to play. So this rule, in terms of actionable clicking around it, you had to have your guard up on that. So that one was a little more difficult. All right, but now we're fully crossed. Look at the red. Look, red way below yellow. So our pink circle, most recent. People celebrating. No, you're falling with style. And now this time, which is why this, okay, look, this is why I'm super confused. Okay. Like just look at this. Price isn't even above or touching the 10 EMA. How are people bullish? We're in a downtrend with the red accelerating away from the yellow, which means the move is accelerating to the downside. And people saying, we're already back above 50K. No, no. Celebrate this cross or celebrate a higher high, a local high or a higher local low. Now, could you celebrate if price went like this, made a lower low or a higher low and then move back up something like here and then say, yes, we're at, you know, but that would take you to like 58K. There is no celebration until roughly that level. You need to get above this stuff. All right. Or if what happens, we create a high here. So maybe let's say we create a high around 56K, but still don't celebrate. You're falling with style. Then you make a higher low, right? Actually, that's not a higher low even. 58K, you make a higher low, and then you get back right up to 55. Okay. That is maybe celebrate 55K because you formed a higher low and you're getting ready to form a higher high. Therefore, the trend, you will get a green box here if that were to happen. So yes, in that case, sure, celebrate this little move up to 55K. But sure, like there is no reason to be celebrating. Like it's just like there's no reason. Is this so? I'm going to show you one more thing with these green boxes to make this super simple to remember. But before we do, I will try to be nice the rest of this. Flip your phones vertically because right now it's horizontal. Hit the like button. Take your finger. Smash it. Thank you. And I'll leave me a quick comment. It's going to help me continue making videos for you because it helps the algo and it helps me continue making these videos for you. Okay, all that stuff might be for me, but here's what's for you. Hit the bell because this will allow me to deliver time-sensitive information to you more efficiently. Hit the bell. That part's for you. We're in this together. Let's dive back in. Make sure you're following me on Twitter, Cosas Verdes, with the number 2 at the end. It's in the description section of all my videos, at Cosas Verdes, number 2 on Twitter. Giggity, giggity, let's jump back. Let's go back in time one more time and look at the red boxes, okay? All right, so tell me, what happened after every single red box? You get a falling with style. You get a falling with style, right? Red box. Pink squiggle, which means falling with style, right? Okay, another red box. Guess what? Pink, falling with style. Technically, there was no trend reversal here because this was a higher low. These weren't considered lows. So that's why that was really hard to trade. All right, so red box up here. Red box. See this red box? Okay, what happened just after falling with style? What happened again after it? Another falling with style? You got two falling with styles. Look. Red box. Guess what happened right after? Falling with style. And again, that was a tricky play. Look here. Red box. Look what we have. Falling with style. Guess what's going to happen next? Probably a pink line. We're going to fall with style again. Maybe make a higher low. And then you celebrate. Is this making sense? I know I can't save the world. And I know I'm kind of like a, you know, being a dick in this. And I know, but this is, I promise you, this is going to help you so much. So you're not like taking longs and stuff like that. Like if you're playing long, you have to take your profits very quickly. It's actually better to play short right now or just no trade at all, which is It's kind of my position right now, because I think I really want a higher low after this. And so I'm allowing what I want to create a little bit of biasness, and just instead of trading the trend, I don't know. There's something in me saying, but but the statistics are against my gut. Therefore, I'm not going to try to trade long, because I'm observing my bias to the upside. And statistics say you're an idiot. And so like they're saying it to me, right? Like I'm mean to myself, right? I'm not just mean to you. And so when I notice that my bias and I just can't get that gut feeling out, I don't trade. If the statistics are against what I want to do, and I just can't get myself to trade with the trend, I don't trade at all, right? And I don't make comments on social media about we're back up above 50K. It's Buzz Lightyear. All right. If you want to know how to play bottoms better, click this video here. If you want to learn how to set up a chart like mine so you can make more money in crypto, because you might be newer to this, click this link here. And if you're new to my channel and you haven't subscribed, hit this circle. It's waiting for you. No, seriously, this circle here, it is for you. It's my present to you. Click it. Click it. It'll pop up balloons and it'll be all pretty. Click that circle. See you later. Just got Timified.